views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Hi, welcome. This is Dr. John DeMartini. This is one of the most amazing and inspiring shows that you can listen into. If you want to be on the edge of your seats, if you want to open up your heart, if you want to expand your mind, and you want to meet incredible people, stay tuned because you're just about to experience a transformative radio show that will change your life. And you're listening to the Dr. Pat Show that's coming up right next.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Powerful, inspiring, and coming to you live, bringing you stories of people like you and me, busting through and living life full out. Get ready to dare to wonder what your life would be like if you knew you could not fail. Hey, everybody, welcome. Welcome. I want to welcome you. Welcome. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. Guess who I am? I'm Dr. Pat. Yay for, well, I don't know. Yay for me. Do I say that? Hello, Mr. Benny.
Howdy.
Howdy, partner. Oh, I got to breathe. Oh, what a great show we've got going on here. I have to breathe about today's topic. And the reason I got to breathe is because, you know, this is a hot one. Not that they aren't all hot when it comes to Dr. Friedemann Schaub. I'm just saying, like, this one today, it is a kicker. It really is. This is the Empowered Self series. My co-host joining me here, Dr. Friedemann Schaub, part 11. How to make trust the antidote to fear. Oh, boy. Well, I have to tell you, this is probably one of the most important conversations that Dr. Friedemann and I have had. And there is a lot to talk about with this. You know, everything from who we trust in to what we trust to whether or not we learn it, whether it's a natural ability, how it shows up, what happens when we don't. You know, what is the problem with not trusting? Well, and then one of my favorites. Wait a minute. We're trusting too much. What does that even mean? Dr. Friedemann Schaub joining me here today, award-winning author of The Fear and Anxiety Solution, co-founder, who else was with him? Nobody. Founder of Cellular Wisdom, a personal breakthrough and empowerment program. He works with people all over the world. Been doing it for over 15 years, helping people step into their fullest ability, potential, and live the lives truly meant to live. You know, whether it's through the personal breakthrough and empowerment program, which includes mind-activating technologies, NLP, energy psychology, medical hypnotherapy, timeline therapy, and beyond, you will be able to get some help so that you can increase and improve your capacity to heal, change, and succeed in any area of your life. He has worked with people, whether it is anxiety, depression, PTSD, chronic pain, addictions. He has seen it all. And he does something incredible. He will, for those of you out there, if you want to call him for a free telephone consultation, like if you're thinking, well, wait a minute, do I really need help? Well, let me think. I smoke 3 packs of cigarettes a day. I've been stuck in the same job for about 10 years. 866-903-6463. That's his free telephone consultation. And if you think that you want to live an epic life and you're not doing it now, that's another reason to call. It doesn't really matter. You know, a place of discomfort in our lives sometimes can be an amazing indicator of our potentiality to expand beyond the levels of any comfort we have and move beyond mediocrity in our lives. Dr. Friedemann, welcome to the show. It's great to have you.
Well, you have to take a breath. Absolutely. I mean, what an intro. Thank you very much. I always look forward to our time together.
You know, I think that this conversation about trust is so big, I don't even know where to start. And the reason I say it's big is because it seems like trusting is a lost art. And I say that because so many folks don't trust. Don't trust the government. Don't trust the institutions. Don't trust in relationships. Definitely don't trust in the workplace. And we have got a I don't trust epidemic on our hands, don't we?
Absolutely. But I don't think it's necessarily an art. It actually is something that's more a natural capability we all have. I mean, when you really think about if we would come out of the womb not trusting, I mean, you know, what would we do? We would try to crawl away from those big people around us. We would certainly not ask for anything we want and scream for being, you know, the diapers changed or fed because we wouldn't trust that we actually get what we want. I mean, a lot of things wouldn't happen. So there is something that we are naturally born into, which is the ability simply to trust and have confidence that others are going to take care of us. But over time, we are losing that trust, whether it's through hurt, disappointment, betrayal, that, you know, we feel like somehow our needs were not met, and trust gets gradually replaced. You know, it gets replaced by fear and anxiety and insecurity, but it also gets replaced by these patterns, you know, like the pattern of control. And so in some ways, you could say that, you know, trust is no longer, you know, very well kept in our society because most of us feel more comfortable controlling than actually trusting. And I think that level of control, unfortunately, leaves us more in a state of fear and anxiety. And that leaves us, as, you know, one of my favorite topics, is leaves us in the survival mode. And we're never getting really into thriving.
Well, you know, one of the things that I think you also talking about here today is, you know, this idea, the natural ability, you know, that you talk about as we have. And, you know, yet at some times in our lives, something happens where we forget we actually have that natural ability. And, you know, I think that's important to really kind of chat about that, especially, you know, as we pop in here as babies. We have nothing else to do but trust, do we?
Yeah, absolutely. That's all we can really rely on. And that's all we can really also, you know, basically give to those around us. I mean, you know, why is it that there is a natural instinct of a parent to take care of the child? It's not only the amazing loving bond that happens between them, but it's also that the child offers this level of complete surrender and trust. You know, when you really feel like the trust that a child has, it's a gift. It's actually an offering. And that makes, you know, you as the one who's taking care of the child really feel good because you want to match the level of trust that this child is giving you. You know, often people feel trust is, you know, vulnerable. It's actually weak. It's a form of disempowerment. But when you look at it from that perspective, you could say it's actually really empowering because when you really fully trust the people that you offer this trust to, really, especially when you see the child and parent relationship, they want to do something to be worthy of that trust.
Yeah. And, you know, I mean, you know, part of this is really looking at the many layers that that we have in trust when we look at trust. And there are many layers, you know, to talk about here in terms of, you know, what we've come to know, how it shows up in our lives, you know, what it does to inspire us to take action, make decisions, and also how much we trust or don't trust ourselves. And so part of that, Dr. Friedemann, is really understanding what trust is. And, you know, there are many forms of it. Maybe you can enlighten us and give us a little information on what trust looks like.
Well, I think trust in general, you know, it's kind of defined as firmly believing in the reliability, goodness, and truth of, you know, something or someone. But, you know, when you really think about trust and how it can show up, it can actually show up in three ways. And one way is the trust in others. The second way is the trust in ourselves. And then there is a trust in life or a trust in God or universe or a higher power. And these three levels of trust or these three aspects of trust are all completely different. And personally, I believe we have to have a certain kind of hierarchy. What is the most important trust to remember or trust to build? And I believe we need to have trust in ourselves. And then, ideally, we want to have trust in life or trust in the universe. And then, thirdly, have trust in others. And the reason for that is because when we are relating to others, what we often do is we're not realizing that there are three different levels of trust with others. And, you know, I'm happy to talk about this more, but often we are putting trust into others in a way that actually is overwhelming them or is based on too high, unrealistic expectations. And naturally, we're going to get this trust broken. And the three levels are the basic trust, which is basically, you know, when you're going out and you have the trust that is based on rules and other people. So you go out on the street and you assume that people will not, you know, hurt you or steal from you or do any harm to you. That's just a very, very basic level of trust that when you, you know, just go downtown, you basically can have in the people around you. The second level of trust is a trust, you know, that's more experience-based. So when you have coworkers you're working with or the neighbors that, you know, around the house, and there you learn to know the people and you can kind of predict how they will react and behave in the relationship. So that's kind of, you know, a more close trust. But it's still a trust that, you know, doesn't make you necessarily want to share your nightmares or share, you know, vulnerabilities with that person. And then there is a third level of trust, and that's the most personal one, and that's a heart-based trust. And that's a trust where you're able to share your dreams and hopes and strengths and weaknesses with someone else because you feel comfortable. You know them, you feel safe. You assume that this person has your best interest in mind. Now, what happens often with people is that they are skipping these buildings of trust, you know, these steps from the basic level to the second level and the third level, and they learn to know someone, you know, let's say you're dating someone, and immediately you have this feeling of, oh, yeah, I need to go to the third level. I need to share my traumas. I need to share my disappointments. I need to make sure that I can really trust this person. And then the person may not be ready for that communication and that connection and that level of trust. And so maybe that date doesn't end very well, or the person doesn't call back, or maybe after a few times you will not see each other again. And because you have put so much weight on how much you want to trust this person, you end up being disappointed again. And then you're telling yourself, well, see, I cannot trust anyone. But when you step back and take responsibility, you're realizing you are actually not building trust. You are not allowing this trust to naturally unfold and grow. You are forcing it by going to the third level, to the most intimate, heartfelt level, without really knowing what this person is all about. And I think that's one of the most common mistakes, why people don't trust others, because they have skipped the steps to build trust and assumed or given to the relationship some unrealistic expectations.
Well, you know, this is really kind of, you know, for me, this is really a game changer. You know, this conversation, Dr. Friedemann Schaub joining me here today, and as a matter of fact, you know, this is very, very cool. The whole Empowered Self series is amazing. And, you know, this particular topic, we're talking about trust, but, you know, but how does this relate to fear? And, you know, what's interesting is I have come to know fear so, so well. It is scary. But I'm glad that I know Dr. Friedemann Schaub for sure. His book, The Fear and Anxiety Solution, it is, first of all, it's an award-winning book, but I don't need to say that. It's also an amazing book. He's got CDs that go with it. And as I said before, schedule your personal time with him. It is life-changing. Let's take a short break. When we come back, we're not just going to talk about the problem with not trusting. We're going to talk about what the relationship is between trust and fear. How does it show up in our lives? How do you know it's showing up? And is fear the great indicator for how we get beyond the beyond? Stay tuned. We'll be right back with the Dr. Pat Show.
To The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Tired of traditional talk? People pontificating about this or that, the left or the right. Sometimes the truth is just all lost in the noise. Tune in each week to Straight Talk with Chuck Gallagher on TransformationTalkRadio.com, Mondays at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern, as nationally known guests talk about what's important to you, your life, your concerns, and your success. Tune in and turn on to Straight Talk with Chuck Gallagher. Visit ChuckGallagher.com for more information.
Listen to the Yo Andrew News talk show every Tuesday night at 5 p.m. Pacific Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. More info where to listen, www.yoandrewnts.com/listen. Don't get your message lost in the mail. Email us with this address, yoandrew@yoandrewnts.com. How about tweet Yo Andrew at AndrewTweetGeo. Taking a picture is easy. Instagram us today at yoandrewnts.
Join Dr. Pat Basile for an extraordinary event right here in the Pacific Northwest. The Global Women's Summit, presented by the Women's Information Network, is coming to Bellevue. Join us as we discover life and wealth mastery techniques and promote success and happiness for women worldwide. Saturday, November 22nd, from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. at the Maidenbauer Center in Bellevue, Washington. Register online now at thewinonline.com and don't miss out.
Wondering how to play the game of life and actually win? Stop wondering and start winning the game of life with the unique, incomparable Lynn Brown. Lynn takes everyday aspects of life and infuses them with the magic of soul and passion to help others. She wants to help you next. Lynn offers a myriad of spiritual healing, from chakra clearing, aura healing, to even corporate and business readings. Bring your game face and visit letter R, letter U, Intuit.com or call 844 letter B, Intuit.
Hi, I'm Dr. Pat. I'd like to share with you a recipe directly from my friends at Galeo's Cafe website. Try this barbecue lamb marinade and Galeo's miso marinade. Get your lamb shoulder cut into cubes and put into a deep dish. Add salt and pepper to taste, then fresh garlic. Yum! 3 tablespoons of olive oil and 6 tablespoons of Galeo's miso sesame seed dressing marinade, and leave overnight in the refrigerator. The Galeo's miso dressing will bring out the best taste of the lamb and make it very, very tender. Then you can barbecue the next day. This recipe is directly from Chef Andre himself, so we know it's going to be delicious. For more information and to order your dressing today, visit galeoscafe.com. That's GALEOS Cafe.com, or ask for the dressings at your local grocery store. Remember, shipping is free.
Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
Now you know.
man, this is such a great show. Welcome, everyone. I'm Dr. Pat. Thanks for tuning us in, turning us on. You know, if you want to find out more about us, you can go to the Dr. Wait, I've got to get this right. Twitter, the Dr. Pat Show, Facebook, the Dr. Pat Show, drpatshow.com, or Transformation Talk Radio. If you want to find out more about Dr. Friedemann Schaub, my friend, colleague, great radio series that we're doing with him, you can go to his website, which is amazing. He's actually got a couple of them, but I'll tell you what they are. You can go to the fearandanxietysolution.com, and you're going to see lots of information about him, about his book, his CDs, about his work, or you could go to cellularwisdom.com. And then the thing I'd like to say to all of you is, if you are even contemplating whether or not you're at a place of stuckness in your life, just give him a call for this free telephone consultation. I am so amazed that he has been doing this for the years and years and years that he has been co-hosting here with me. And that number is 866-903-6463. And later on in the show, we're going to be hearing from someone that has and is working with Dr. Friedemann. If you want to know about fear, he is your go-to person. Beyond all of that, if you want to heal, he is the person you want to give a call to. Dr. Friedemann, thank you for joining me here today on the show. You know, I mean, there are so many things to talk about here, but also to talk about the relationship between fear and trusting. And I know you are the go-to man for the fear conversation, aren't you?
Well, you know, I had my fair share of it myself, yeah. So yeah, I mean, I definitely, like many of us, know fear very intimately, and yeah, I mean, I think fear and trust seem almost like mutually exclusive, and you know what fear is doing, and you have to understand that I don't see fear as a disorder or some kind of a brain freak or, you know, something is wrong with you. It's usually something deep inside that just needs our attention, that just needs to have some kind of resolution out of a confusion that often comes way back from, you know, when we were very young and very little. And often when we were not able to build a strong foundation of trust. See, that's what happens when we are, you talked about, you pop out as a baby, you have all this, you know, built-in trust, it's all you can do, things are going fine, but eventually what happens is that you're not experiencing unconditional love and acceptance any longer. All of a sudden, there are expectations. All of a sudden, the teachers, the parents, the siblings want you to be different, want you to do things that you may not really want to do, or all of a sudden you get judged, or all of a sudden you get criticized. All of a sudden you feel like there are these boundaries that basically what I'm saying is that these experiences are confusing. And based on those experiences, often that natural ability to trust gets lost. And as a response, our mind, especially our subconscious, is gravitating towards fear. It's gravitating towards anxiety because that's what the subconscious does. It tries to keep us safe, and it uses fear and anxiety to make us alert of potential danger. Now, when we are in that anxiety and fear mode, and when we don't really feel like we can trust, usually we are going to one of four ways of trying to make it through life. And those ways, we talked about those before, are either to avoid anything that potentially could harm us and be dangerous, or we are trying to please those that we feel can potentially judge us or hurt us, or we are trying to control all our circumstances or the people around us to make sure that we are somewhat safe. Or we become these overachievers that are just always having to be the first and the best, because that gives us a safety net or a sense of being more secure and belonging in the world. All of those things are basically the opposite of building trust. And so what's important in this conversation is to really understand more what are actually the the natural enemies to trust. Why are we not trusting more? And what can we do to build more trust? And what can we do to actually build trust with ourselves, but also then with life and others around us?
I kind of want to get Pat back into the conversation. We're having some technical difficulties. Our apologies here on the old internet. We are having some heavy winds here in the south there, Friedman. So let's just go ahead and take a quick break. You are listening to the Dr. Pat Show, being brought to you by the Transformation Talk Radio Network, and we'll be right back.
I've been trying to do it right. Hey! I've been living a lonely life. Ha! I've been sleeping here instead. Hey! I've been sleeping in my bed. Ha! Sleeping in my bed.
Tune in to Psychic Cup of Coffee with Kelly Sutliff every Tuesday, 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Time on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Kelly is a 14-year veteran of psychic ability, and she offers inspiration and comfort to those dealing with grief when they have lost a loved one, and also shares with people that the psychic world is very real. Call 1-800-930-2819 during the show with your questions and visit PsychicMediumKelly.com. That's PsychicMediumKelly.com.
Tune in to Sheer Alchemy with Leslie Fontaine on TransformationTalkRadio.com and get ready to stir up your passions, identify your blocks, and shift into an entirely new existence. Leslie Fontaine is a transformation catalyst and clairvoyant who uses her intuitive and energetic gifts to catapult listeners into living the life they were born to live. Whether it's shifting from scarcity to abundance, from emotional pain into joy, or from illness into health, Leslie will help you step into the true essence and power of all that you are with the help of the Ascended Masters and Archangels. You will not be the same. Visit TransformationTalkRadio.com for show dates and times and LeslieFontaine.com to say yes to explosive abundance.
Hello, my name is Dr. Friedemann Schaub.
Anxiety can attack or creep up on us at the most inopportune moments, which makes us feel powerless and out of control. However, anxiety is a basic feeling that is created by our mind. Understanding some do's and don'ts about anxiety is a first step to demystify this emotion and regain control. The more we know about a challenge, the more we can find ways to overcome it.
Get sophisticated with David and Philip Zarza. David and Philip touch on topics such as human potential, spirituality, pop culture, and purposeful living. Experience an insightful reading from David on what the universe has in store for you, or reconnect with a departed loved one. Philip can look into an issue or anything else you may be dealing with. Go to getsophisticated.com. That's SOPHISTIGAYTED.com or call 206-420-8660.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Galios miso dressings are delicious and made with only the finest, freshest, and all-natural ingredients. Galios miso dressings are low in fat, sugar, salt, and carbohydrates. They do not contain any artificial ingredients or any wheat, eggs, vegetable gums, or MSG. What they do contain is astonishing flavor and silky texture that can only come from using premium quality ingredients. Order online with free shipping at www.galeoscafe.com. That's GALEOSCafe.com.
Me. I don't know where I belong. I don't know where I went wrong. But I can write a song. I belong with you. You belong with me, my sweetheart.
Welcome back. Yeah, you just got to trust that everything's working out exactly the way it should work out. Dr. Friedemann Schaub is joining me here today, but I don't know if that's exactly right. You know, trust is a very big topic, and it means different things for different people. And that's what, you know, I love about Dr. Friedemann Schaub and what he talks about. You know, it's talking about the many, many layers that we call ourselves, you know, whatever is going on in this human skin that we have here and how we live our lives. And there are some of us that have played very, very small at the game of life, as my friend Lynn Brown would say. And then there are others that have decided to play bigger. You know, what's the difference between the two? Well, that's why we have Dr. Friedemann Schaub here today. You know, there are some things with trust, Dr. Schaub, that many, many, many people are not aware of, things that are happening that prevent us from understanding the dynamic of it or even understanding how to become more trusting. Maybe you could talk to some of those things.
Well, you know, I think what trust actually, or what the conversation is really about, is to bring trust a little bit more in the forefront of our minds, because it's really undervalued. When you are remembering times, or when you are in relationships right now with someone or with yourself, and you feel trust, then you know how amazingly powerful trust can be. Trust gives you really a sense of peace. It really gives you a sense of reliability, and it gives you a sense of also ease to move forward in life. And at the beginning, we talked about how we are often putting these unrealistic expectations on others, which then makes us end up feeling hurt and betrayed. And this is why I think it's so important to really build a greater level of trust within ourselves. But when you really think about it, and that's something I would like you all, including myself, to be honest about, what we are often expecting from others when it comes to trust, are we really giving this to ourselves? Are we really giving ourselves the reliability that we are hoping others would give us? Are we giving ourselves the kindness, the support, the care that we are expecting or assuming others should provide us with? And the answer is often no. Often we are the worst with ourselves. We are letting ourselves always come late. We are not necessarily feeding ourselves in time. We are not necessarily true to our word. We are saying, yeah, tomorrow I'm going to go to the gym, and we don't do it. We are not necessarily paying our bills. So there's a lot of things we are doing to ourselves that actually are the opposite of building trust. And naturally then, because we all need some level of trust, we are gravitating to others and hoping they will provide us with that, what we are not able to provide for ourselves. And that always, you know, ends up more in a state of feeling disempowered than feeling empowered. So taking really responsibility and looking at your own behavior and asking yourself, if someone else would treat you this way, would you trust that person? And if the answer is no, then you know where you have to start.
Well, you know, when we look at our lives, I mean, we look at some of the things that show up as barriers or obstacles in our lives. And, you know, I don't know about you, but, you know, there have been times in my life where I just could not connect all the dots. And, mm-hmm. you know, what that means is, and as we talked about before, the relationship between trust and fear. You know, some people would look at that and be able to connect the dot very easily. But most of us cannot connect the dots. And that's why, you know, I said before, for those people out there that want to talk with you about a free consultation, it's important to do. Because most of the time in my life, other people have been able to see things way before that I could see them. You know, including, you know, my propensity to trust people automatically. You know, right out of the get-gate, I trust you. I don't even know you. And I want to say that that's my makeup. Now, it drives my best friend Linda crazy. But is that true? I mean, are some of us predetermined to be more trusting than others or less trusting? And what is the detriment of that?
Well, it really depends. If you are trusting others more than you're trusting yourself, then you're coming more from a need, and you're basically projecting that need onto others, and you want those people to give you what you need. So that's one way of, you know, basically putting all caution in the wind and saying, no, I'm going to trust this going to be the person who's going to make me happy, or this going to be the person who's going to be my friend or help me out of loneliness. And that's, you know, again, that usually ends up in hurt, because we cannot necessarily put those expectations onto others. But if you're trusting others because you feel very secure within yourself, and you feel like, yeah, of course, I can see their flaws, I can see their issues, and I can be completely okay if they are not doing exactly what they say they would or what I hope they would, because I'm my own source, then it's easy to trust. But then it's not a trust that comes from a lack, but it comes actually from a great sense of self-belief, which, you know, is a very safe way to approaching others and connect to others. And it's a way where you can accept others more for who they are. But, you know, the relationship to fear is really an important topic, because I think when we are in a zone of fear, we do usually either keep ourselves in a comfort zone, which naturally doesn't build trust. You know, we are hiding out. We are also not building trust with ourselves, because we're never challenging ourselves. We're never risking anything. We're just keeping it safe. And when you always play it safe, you never really gain trust. And then there is, of course, these unrealistic expectations in ourselves. I mean, there are people that are pushing themselves and always feel like they're coming short and they always want more. That doesn't really build a foundation of trust either, because you're your worst slave driver. Plus, you're not really appreciating what you have accomplished. And trust, as we know with building trust with others, a level of appreciation is really important. How else can you really build trust if you're not feeding back to yourself or the other person that you like what they did, or that you really embrace them for who they are? And then the worst enemy of trust is the control. You know, when we really want to have it exactly our way, when we are very rigid, when we are very micromanaging, when we always have to be the ones in charge, that's exactly the opposite of trust. It may give us a sense of confidence, because we feel like, yeah, we are, you know, basically at the helm, but it's not trusting, because trusting is the opposite of controlling. Trusting has so much more to do with letting go. And so when we are able to step out of the comfort zone, have realistic expectations, when we appreciate what is and accept what is and let go of control, chances are we are actually building trust. And first and foremost, we need to do this with ourselves.
Well, yeah. I mean, we, you know, it's part of really the journey that we go on, you know. And, you know, I've heard some people say, and I know you have too, you know, I've heard people say, I don't trust anybody, and, you know, or anything. And, you know, I don't believe in trust. I think trust is overrated. And I start to think about that. And I also think about, you know, what would life be like if I didn't trust people? You know, would I have my best friend of 40-something years? Probably not. And there's so much that we would miss out. And I love what you were talking about before when you talked about the relationship between trust and fear. I mean, these are two peas in a pod, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, you know, I think having gone through long stretches of my own fear and anxiety, and you know, really having done it all, avoidance, control, pleasing, yeah, achieving, and really tested it all, I know at some point I realized that my biggest issue is not fear and anxiety. My biggest issue is that I couldn't trust.
Right.
And so I realized really that I don't need to chase fear and anxiety. I need to understand how can I actually learn to trust. And that's it's actually a very empowering journey in itself when you take it serious.
Well, and, you know, part of this is really taking a look at what our lives would be like if we didn't trust. You know, I mean, we trust some very basic and essential things. We trust that if we're driving our car, right, and we're driving it down a hill, the brakes are going to work. We also trust that when the light turns green, it really means green, and we can go through. You know, so there are some things that we have been conditioned and trained to trust. And without that training and trust, But when it comes to the more fungi stuff, you know, the things that are not black and white or put in cast in concrete, you know, or that come to do with the relationship we have with each other or even our higher power, you know, if that's what you believe in, it really brings up an entirely different conversation, which will take us down the pathway in life that we don't really want to go. We're going to take a short break right here, and when we come back, more with the conversation that we're having with Dr. Friedemann Schaub. It's so great to have him here. We're going to make sure you have plenty of information about him. This is our The Empowered Self series. My co-host, Dr. Friedemann Schaub, Part 11, How to Make Trust the Antidote to Fear. Stay tuned, everyone. We'll be right back with the show.
What day is it? And in what month? This clock never seems so alive.
The Read of a Lifetime. Advanced Studies of the Human Aura by David Christopher Lewis overflows with new vital revelations to enlighten your mind and transform your world. Learn to supercharge your aura with rainbow-colored radiance and magnetize your heart's highest desires. Advanced Studies of the Human Aura. It will change how you see yourself. Advanced Studies of the Human Aura by David Christopher Lewis. Order it today at davidclewisbook.org.
Join Dr. Pat Basile for an extraordinary event right here in the Pacific Northwest. The Global Women's Summit, presented by the Women's Information Network, is coming to Tacoma. Join us as we discover life and wealth mastery techniques and promote success and happiness for women worldwide. Saturday, November 15th from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. at Pacific Lutheran University in Tacoma, Washington. Register online now at thewinonline.com and don't miss out. Are you ready to experience the power of three, the power of being mentally, physically, and spiritually fit? We tend to think in this society that we have to choose one and that to live in balance with all three is taboo or impossible. Lynn Brown will show you how to combine these energies to give you ease and power that is out of this universe. Lynn's workshop will be held at the Maya Whole Health Center studio in Renton, Washington on November 22nd from 5 to 7 p.m. Call them directly to register at 425-271-0200.
Are you ready to tap into the healer within? Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. Did you know the real doctor is the source that lives within you, that heals within you minute by minute every day? The healer within is the innate intelligence of the human body. When we cut our hand with a piece of glass, we don't have to command the body to close the wound and grow new skin. It knows how to heal itself. We do have to nourish the skin by disinfecting it and remove the glass, or it cannot heal. The innate healer relies upon us to assist in this healing process. Our role is to identify its needs, provide the substances required for the healing, and remove the obstacle. Contact us to achieve optimal health at 888-777-4232. That's 888-777-4232. And visit us at MaryJaneMack.com.
Tune in to Heart Center Talk Radio with David Christopher Lewis, a gifted clairaudient, Aquarian spiritual author, and talented musical composer on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Every Wednesday, 9 a.m. Pacific Time, 12 p.m. Eastern Time, with delivering more than 4,000 messages from angels, masters, and divine beings, David will share the Ascended Master's teachings, insights, and surprising revelations to light bearers. Meet transformative guests who embody change and inspire hope, and get a refreshing and deeply meaningful perspective on life.
And I can't back down, I've been losing so much time. 'Cause there's you and me and all other people, nothing to do, nothing to lose.
Hey everybody, welcome back. Welcome back. Dr. Friedemann Schaub joining us here today. Mr. Benny, we have a guest caller.
Yeah, we'll take Kristen calling in from Seattle.
Hi. Hello. Kristen.
Hi.
Hey there.
Hi, Kristen. You know, I'm so glad that you are calling in, and I trusted that you will call in. But it's really nice because Chris and I worked together starting in March, and we, you know, basically really have explored together a lot about how to change from a control mode into a level of fundamental trust. And I think you, Kristen, would agree that for most of your life you were more in the survival and control mode, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Now, how did your control look like? So what do you feel like were like your patterns that made you feel somehow safer?
Well, I think I developed unhealthy coping mechanisms that would provide me with a little bit of comfort. And just being a perfectionist and thinking that if I'm in control of everything, that was just going to make me feel safer. And it really didn't. It was kind of the opposite of that, to be honest.
What were kind of the downsides of trying to push yourself hard to be perfect? What did you notice over time actually happened?
Well, I just had a lot of anxiety, and I had these unrealistic standards for myself that I could never meet. So there was, feeling uncomfortable and not feeling like I was good enough, and, just very, very hard on myself. So there was no vulnerability. There was no openness. There was no compassion for me.
And what about your relationships?
Well, it was safer for me to keep everybody at a distance and not really open myself up to being, again, vulnerable or, kind or patient because I didn't feel comfortable with myself. So I was pretty much alone for a long time in this pattern.
And did you realize that this pattern started early in your life? And what do you feel like triggered this pattern?
It definitely started early in my life, and I had some codependent issues with my family. My father in particular was an alcoholic and didn't pay much attention to me, and so I did everything I could to be, this overachiever and perfectionist to try to get his attention, and that just kind of carried on throughout my teens and into my adult life.
Mm-hmm. And so, just realizing that, I think what you also felt was that it wasn't sustainable to live this way because you tried to be in charge, you tried to control, but the outcome were actually you feeling more out of control when the slightest things happened that were not really, what you planned or what you had foreseen. It brought up a lot of fear and anxiety for you. How would you say was your journey to gain trust, and what do you feel like were some of the stepping stones to get there?
Well, I think that, working with you obviously was a key turning point for me. And looking back at where this originated and why I've been so hard on myself, and I think that I look now at myself in a gentler way, and I'm just more compassionate with who I am and accepting myself for where I'm at in my life. I also had a kind of a life-changing event happen to me. I witnessed a shooting in my neighborhood out back from my house. And it was one of those things where I had absolutely no control over what was going on. And I had to just trust the universe and trust myself that I could deal with the situation. And what happened was I was able to protect myself and my family, and I handled the situation with being calm and relaxed and knowing what I needed to do. So I think for me that just really signified that, hey, the universe is happening, and it's watching, and it's active, and I don't have to have control over everything. So that was pretty significant to me.
Yeah, I remember when you told me this, and I think what was amazing is it was just like, 5 months after you started this journey. And if you think back how you would have at the beginning of the year responded to something so out of control, what do you think you would have done?
Well, I would have panicked and I would have just been closed off from the whole situation. But what happened was is that after I processed what happened, I just felt a lot more comfortable with myself and confidence I think I had. And also just living in the moment. I mean, gosh, that person is no longer alive. And, I'm here today, and this is the moment that I'm living in. And that's what I have to focus on, and not all these,
structure and routines and rigidness that I had lived in the past. So I'm taking it a lot more as a day-to-day journey. And I know that the universe is at work constantly. That's the thing that reinforced it for me.
You know, that's so empowering what you just said, because for someone who doesn't trust and who feels in a situation where someone gets killed right in front of our eyes, naturally it feels completely out of control, disempowering, and all we can really focus on is the sense of unsafety. But your mind actually shifted to life is so precious, I need to enjoy it more. And that's really remarkable, how safety wasn't the first thing in your mind. It was more like, how can you actually even more appreciate what we have right now? And that certainly signifies a lot of how much trust you have built. But what do you feel like for you are the daily steps that you're still taking that help you to stay on track and continue to build more trust?
Well, I check in with myself and my higher self and universe every day, and I just I ask for guidance. And the thing is, I have to start my day with being open and being vulnerable and being gentle and kind, and not trying to plan out so far in advance that I can't keep up with everything. I'm much more living in the moment, and you know, it's a shift in consciousness and just being really radically trusting in the universe in the process.
Do you also treat yourself better in terms of your self-talk and how you are thinking? And do you keep your thoughts actually, you know, guided in a more appreciative and trusting direction?
Right. Absolutely. Yeah. Like I said, I'm much more gentle with myself, and I accept myself for where I'm at, and I embrace the process. And instead of trying to fight it or control it, which I realize now I just can't do, I don't have that energy, and I don't want to focus on that anymore.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, how much would you call yourself in the past a controller?
Oh, 9 plus.
And now, how much would you say you're a controller?
Well, I have to be honest. I'm still a little bit of a perfectionist and a control person, but no. I would say I'm maybe a 3 or 4. So there's been a radical change for me.
You know, what's so nice about your story is, and you know, when we met first, I think you admitted that all this controlling gave you a sense of safety and familiarity, but at the same time, it also drained you, and it really potentially would have threatened your health. And you had done that for decades. And being able to change and remember to trust, and trusting yourself, treating yourself with greater kindness and acceptance and appreciation, and then opening up to trust the universe and trust also others to be vulnerable and not always perfect around them. And you have been accomplishing this in a very short amount of time. That just shows what we are capable of. And
yeah.
And I think for everyone, you know, you're an inspiration, because, you know, so many people are feeling stuck in their not trusting, in their fears, in their anxieties, and in their control modes. And they don't believe that with their rigidity that they have been living, they can get ever out of it. And you just show it's possible, and there are keys and ways to do it. And one thing that I want to just mention to also highlight what you have been saying one day, the keys for you were that you actually trusted the process, and that you said, I need to simply trust whatever, you know, I was telling you, whatever we discussed and the homework I gave you, you needed to trust that this is going to lead you in the right way. So
yeah.
Once you had that trust given, you were actually able to build trust inside of yourself.
You know, this is, Dr. Friedemann, you know, this is really the perfect example of what happens when you step back and you recognize that something's going on in your life. You're not exactly sure, but you know you need to do something differently, and you reach out and you get some help with it. And step into the world of unlimited possibilities. What a great show. Thank you both for joining us here today.
Thank you very much, Kristen, for calling back. That's super. Thank you.
Yeah. One last question. What's your personal message, Dr. Friedman? Tell folks, what would you like to leave us with?
Well, I really would like you to practice trusting every day a little bit, trusting yourself. Simply think about how much you actually can change how you feel about life and the world you're in when you are treating yourself the way you want to be treated by others, and this way create a stronger connection of trust within yourself. It is not very difficult to do. It really just takes awareness and commitment. And I think we all owe it to ourselves to give that.
I love it. Dr. Friedman Schaub, everyone, check it out, thefearandanxietysolution.com or Cellular Wisdom. Very powerful. If you've missed any part of this, it'll replay again tonight. Thank you so much, Dr. Friedman, for a great show.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. Thanks for tuning us in and turning us on. Remember, you can choose how you want to show up in the world. You can choose trust or you can choose fear. I know what I'm taking. We'll see you next time.
Lights go out and I can be saved. Tides that I tried to swim again.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Tired of traditional talk? People pontificating about this or that, the left or the right. Sometimes the truth is just all lost in the noise. Tune in each week to Straight Talk with Chuck Gallagher on TransformationTalkRadio.com, Mondays at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern, as nationally known guests talk about what's important to you, your life, your concerns, and your success. Tune in and turn on to Straight Talk with Chuck Gallagher. Visit ChuckGallagher.com for more information.
Listen to the Yo Andrew News talk show every Tuesday night at 5 p.m. Pacific Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. More info where to listen, www.yoandrewnts.com/listen. Don't get your message lost in the mail. Email us with this address, yoandrew@yoandrewnts.com. How about tweet Yo Andrew at AndrewTweetGeo? Taking a picture is easy. Instagram us today at yoandrewnts.
Join Dr. Pat Basile for an extraordinary event right here in the Pacific Northwest. The Global Women's Summit, presented by the Women's Information Network, is coming to Bellevue. Join us as we discover life and wealth mastery techniques and promote success and happiness for women worldwide. Saturday, November 22nd, from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. at the Maidenbauer Center in Bellevue, Washington. Register online now at thewinonline.com and don't miss out.
Wondering how to play the game of life and actually win? Stop wondering and start winning the game of life with the unique, incomparable Lynn Brown. Lynn takes everyday aspects of life and infuses them with the magic of soul and passion to help others. She wants to help you next. Lynn offers a myriad of spiritual healing, from chakra clearing, aura healing, to even corporate and business readings. Bring your game face and visit letter R, letter U, Intuit.com or call 844 letter B, Intuit.
Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
If you look on the back of a Galeos dressing label, you'll see one taste and you're hooked for life. And you know what? That's the truth. I love this stuff. Try mixing the Caesar dressing with broccoli and sunflower seeds for a simple and delicious salad. Visit GaleosCafe.com and order your dressings online. That's G-A-L-E-O-S-K. cafe.com.